Today I will show you how to make digital typography by first making your typography on paper and then moving it to Illustrator without the use of a Wacom tablet. What is up people, Tom back again with Satori Graphics. A quick reminder that I do now upload 6 times per week, and across my channel I aim to put out content that covers all areas of graphic design, from artistic to technical. So expect a wide range of content from me here on Satori Graphics. 3 video uploads ago I put out a video on how to make hand lettering typography with a Wacom tablet in Illustrator. A subscriber asked if I could make a tutorial on how to make typography from scratch with pen and paper and then move it to Illustrator, resulting in some digital typography. So today, I have a quick video on 2 ways you can do this very easily, starting on paper and finishing in Illustrator with digital typography designs. This process first requires that you create your hand lettering on paper either with a pencil or pen, or you can use typography ink pens to create some hand lettering. I here have a very simple ink tag that I made. The photo quality is not the best, but I'm just showing you the technique here, and you will see later that it's very easy to clean up the quality in Illustrator. You can make a tag like I have done, or you can go all out and make some really detailed fancy typography. Whatever it is you do, take a picture of it and transfer it over into your Mac or PC, and then upload it to Illustrator. From here, you have 2 options. Firstly, you must lock the image itself and then grab the pen tool. You then will manually create the paths around the lettering to create your digital typography. This process can take a while, but you have complete control over each and every single anchor point on the path. The second option is to use the Live Image Trace tool. You must have the image unlocked and then select it. Then open the Image Trace window like so. From here you can choose your settings. You can use fixed preset settings that are available, or you can manually do it yourself. For this, you must select the Ignore White option, so the background is not vectorized too. Once you're happy with your results, then go up to Object, Image Trace, and Expand. Your typography is now vectorized. From here you can then take the white selection tool and go into your lettering and edit it so that it's smoother, or however you want it to be. A quick tip which I've done is to go up to Object, Path and then Simplify. This will really smoothen the edges of your lettering. I'm personally going for an ink hand style on my typography, so I don't want it to be too perfect. I've set up a Satori Graphics store on Designed by Humans, which is an online t-shirt printing site. As for now, I have 3 designs, both in white and black versions. You can choose a wide selection of colours, and they are fitting t-shirts, hoodies, sweaters, and pullovers for both guys and girls. I have both sold and bought from their printing service before in the past, but that was quite a long time ago, and the quality was grey. But to make sure, I have purchased one of my own shirts, which will be coming in the mail soon, and when it does arrive, I will do an unboxing video on my channel. So if you want to help me out on Satori Graphics with my channel, and you have something physical like a shirt, maybe wait until I get my shirt in the mail, or you can go ahead and pick up one now for yourself. Let me know if you found this video on how to take your typography sketches and finish up with digital designs in Illustrator helpful. Let me know in the comment section below. Subscribe to stay updated to all of my graphic design uploads, and leave a like on your way out. So until next time, design your future today. Peace.